Hello, my name is Christina, and today we're going to talk about ovarian cysts. In this video, we'll explain what they are, why they appear, the symptoms, how we diagnose them, and what treatments are indicated for them. Finally, we'll end up this video answering some frequently asked questions our users have about this topic. Ovarian cysts are fluid-filled sacs that appear on the ovaries. It can be on the surface of the ovaries or inside of them. They form during ovulation and they generally don't have any pain associated to them. It's very important to have a lookout and diagnose them as soon as possible due to the fact that if left untreated, they can have severe injuries or damages in our health. Ovarian cysts appear during the normal functioning of the ovaries during ovulation. These cysts are called functioning cysts. We can distinguish two main ones. First, we have the follicle cyst. These cysts are formed when there is a malfunction of the release of the egg. The egg doesn't properly release, forming a cyst. This cyst can be up to 2.5 centimeters and it goes on its own in about 2 to 3 menstrual cycles. Then we have a different kind of cyst that it's called corpus luteum cyst. This cyst forms once the egg has exited the follicle. The empty follicle is filled with fluid again, and there is where we have our second cyst. These cysts are a little bigger. They can be up to 3 centimeters, and they reabsorb in about 2 to 3 weeks. Generally, we have the most common type, which is the functional cyst. But we also have some less frequent types of cysts that can also affect us. First, we have the serous cystadenoma. This is a cyst that is filled with a clear liquid, and it's quite large in shape and size. Then we have a Mycenae cystadenoma. This is a cyst filled with a bluish-gray liquid. It's round, smooth on the outside, and pretty large in size. They do appear to be round. Then we have endometrioma. These are formed by the endometriosis tissue. They are usually cysts filled with a dark chocolate liquid, and they are from the endometriosis tissue cells. And lastly, we have the dermoid cyst. These cysts are from germ cells that can be a malignant tumor. So the most important thing we have to take into account is that we have to get our checkups regularly, go to the gynecologist so they can diagnose and pick up on any cysts we may have. Generally, ovarian cysts don't have symptoms, a mild discomfort generally, but if left untreated, it can get to very severe symptoms like pelvic or abdominal pain, nausea, dyspareunia, which it would be pain during intercourse. We have nausea, vomiting, tender breast, and problems with the rectum and the bladder. You could feel pressure at these points. It's very important to identify these symptoms and go get them checked out as soon as possible if you do feel some of these symptoms, especially if you have abdominal or pelvic pain, acute pain, very strong pain, mixed with fever. If you do present these symptoms, you should go to the emergency room. This kind of pain mixed with a fever can identify as the rupture of a cyst. One of the cysts has broken and the liquid is inside of your body, which can lead to inflammation and infection. Or there could be a torsion of the ovary. The ovary has torsed on itself, preventing blood flow to reach the ovary, and it could be very dangerous and might need a surgical treatment to save the ovary. To diagnose a cyst, there are several techniques a medical professional can carry away, and we're going to explain these today. First, we would have palpation. These are sacs filled with fluid, so it's easy to identify through palpation. This can be an external, through the stomach, or intravaginally. You can also diagnose cysts with a sonogram, a transvaginal sonogram. The cyst would appear on the ultrasound. It's very important to rule out pregnancy. If the patient is pregnant, the cyst can be formed by the HCG hormone, so it's very important to know if this is the case. Once there is a confirmed diagnosis of cysts, it's very important to do some complementary tests. These would be two mainly, an imaging, so this normal imaging to identify the size and the location of the cyst, and then some blood work to find for a specific marker, the CA125, that can be an indicator that the cyst is a malignant cyst or even a tumor. Once we do have a confirmed diagnosis of a cyst, we are going to treat this cyst depending on the characteristics. It's very important to know the age of the woman, the size of the cyst, where it's located, and the type of cyst that it is. Generally, physicians will try and wait until a couple of weeks have gone by, and you can identify if the cyst has grown in size or if it has shrunk. And once you have this information, you can just leave it and let it reabsorb, or you have to intervene surgically. Nevertheless, it's important to know the woman's age, for example, to try and preserve her fertility. So if we have to surgically remove a cyst, we're going to try to take as less amount of tissue possible to leave a functioning ovary when it's possible. Now we're going to answer the frequently asked questions our users have on this topic. What problems can ovarian cyst cause? The main problem we can find with ovarian cysts is leaving them untreated. They can be very dangerous, they can rupture, and they can affect the ovaries, having to surgically remove one or both of them, and therefore the woman won't be able to get pregnant naturally. Do ovarian cysts require surgical removal? Well, not all of the cysts do. It's very important to know the characteristics of them, the size, and the location. The physician will most likely try and not remove it surgically and see if it develops into shrinking or if it gets bigger. Once that is identified, if we can wait, we would wait. And if not, we would have to remove it surgically. Of course, trying to remove the least amount of tissue possible, but we do have to take into account that you could lose an ovary or both. So thank you so much for watching. I hope this video was interesting. And if you do want to know more about ovarian cysts, do click on the tab where you can read our article.